Okay, so anytime we talk about sales order, we need to take into consideration what happened, what made that sales order possible. A lot of times you'll see something in the background called presales, and this is not considered part of the eight different processes, but it is an important part of sales itself. So some of the activities that we consider presales is things like direct mailing campaign, internet campaign, trade fair, sales activities, telephone inquiries, answering to your quotations, and anything that can potentially trigger a sales can be considered a pre-sales activity. So some of the results, like main result that you can get out of pre-sales activity is your inquiry or request for quotation from your potential customer. And of course, with this, just because they inquire about a product or service, or if they request a quotation from you, that doesn't make it binding. It's not a legally binding document as far as the quotation or request for quotation or their inquiry for your specific product. So, what result that can happen out of pre-sales activity? We're talking about customer inquiry or request for quotation. And so you can get some information during pre-sales processes from your customers or potential customers. And some of these information may include your customer name, their contact phone number, email address, or whatever other things that you can get from them. Now, as far as what can you do with that pre-sales information? You use those particular information to track lost sales or customers, and it can also help negotiate large contracts. And majority of the time, if you're dealing with large organizations, those large organizations, they require some sort of a documentation of the entire sales process from beginning all the way to the end in order for you to do some sort of a deal with them. And that's the only possible way when they decide to maybe cut you a purchase order. So to summarize the pre-sales order, they come before sales order. So sales order is considered the first step of your entire sales and distribution or order to cash processes. So number one is sales order. And of course, with sales order, you're always going to have some sort of pre-sales activity like direct market or direct mail campaign, answering customer inquiries, replying to their requests for quotations, and entering and tracking customers' contact information. Of course, what you're trying to get out of that is some sort of an inquiry or request for quotation, because a lot of the customers or majority out there is not just going to hand you a purchase order without getting some sort of information first. Most of the time, when you're getting a purchase order, that usually means that you've actually dealt with that customer, and that's why they're probably giving you a purchase order without even doing any inquiry or whatnot. Okay, and you can use the information from pre-sales to help you track potentially lost sales or customers. It can also help in negotiating on larger scale contracts, and you may need to ultimately need some sort of documentation to provide for your larger corporation or large organization customers. Okay, so sales order, which is your first step in order to cash. So I keep emphasizing first step, second step, eight steps in total. These steps must be memorized. These steps are very important and they're very critical, and they must come one after another. They're actual steps that you must take in order to get from initial sale all the way to cash. And that's how it works within SAP realm. So basically, sales order is within SAP is an electronic document containing customers' requests for goods or services. It contains all the information that's required in order for you to process that sales order. So when you first create that order within SAP system, The system itself will propose information for the end user or whoever's putting in the sales order. It will propose customers' data from previously stored customers' master data onto the sales order. So that way it avoids you putting in additional or redundant data, and it will also keep you from making an error. And some of the data that you can find on sales order will probably be like company code, sales organization, distribution channel, division, and we will talk about more on these specific organization levels and master data in separate lesson itself, but know that these will be some of the information that are contained within sales order. Like, again, like company code, sales organization, distribution channel, division, among a bunch of other information as well. So another great thing about SAP ERP system is that all the documents and sales process, they're pretty much linked to each other. So when you go to this certain thing called document flow, it allows you to access all the current status history of the sales activity at any given time. And when you display the document flow, it basically shows a linked document. So it may link your pre-sales activity where you got the inquiry or quotation or request for quotation. That may show up within that particular documentation link or document flow. And you can click on those, any of the documents within that link, and be able to move around within the system without any issues. It basically makes it really convenient for you to know or be able to get around and find out different information through document flow, even when you have just one information within the entire process. So again, I'm going to probably go over this every single time, but order to cash business process. We start with sales order, availability check, outbound delivery, picking, goods issue, transportation, billing, and payment processing. Again, I say order to cash because it starts with sales order and then it ends with payment processing, which means cash coming into you.